I've been talking about this class saying it is like a CT, a crypto tips approved way to earn a passive income because proof of stake coins allow you to keep 100% custodianship of your coins. And the coins that I will be mentioning today are ones that I believe have the best bet that you can have for success in the future in terms of like a long-term coin. Welcome to another private live stream class just for you guys. So today we're going to go over staking coins. Topics are going to include staking versus DeFi and essentially how proof of stake coins are different than what you're probably going to be using with DeFi platforms. So Trader Zen, I believe this will be addressing your question that you asked. Why I don't think that you should be using centralized exchanges to stake your coins. Additionally, why I don't think you should choose the lending option compared to proof of stake coins. Wallets that will let you stake your coins while keeping them in your possession. Be going over signs of a pyramid scheme or exit scam. This is definitely aimed more towards, or at 100% aimed towards the DeFi platform. I'll let you know how to find a profitable validator and indications of a quality coin that you will find to be very profitable in the long term. Right off the bat, how staking coins differ from DeFi. Staking coins are designed for this type of emission of coins or rewards. This is what the proof of stake algorithm is all about. You can take advantage of the rewards through staking your coins without the use of a third party because these proof of stake coins were designed for this. Whereas with DeFi, you are required to be interacting with a third party in order to earn a very similar type of passive income. The annual percentage returns are really similar between DeFi platforms and proof of stake platforms, but really I keep thinking of DeFi as a mimic, really a proof of stake coins. Most importantly, even a lot of DeFi platforms saying that they have like a high yield savings account. And so for all you know, really how they're advertising is that for all you know, you are storing your coins in a wallet and you're getting like 5% returned, paid out, however often they've designed it to be per year. So, but what they're really doing is you are either putting those coins into a smart contract, or you are giving those coins over to that third party, and they are taking those coins and lending them out. The profits that they get from lending them out are kicked back to you. You better believe they are getting, like you're getting a fraction of the profits that they're getting, really, because that is their business model. If your goal is to have like a high yield interest rate, passive income through something like that, I would not choose BlockFi. I would not choose any DeFi platform. I would choose a proof of stake coin. If your goal is to, take out a loan so that you can access the value of your crypto without losing your position in that crypto, I think that could be smart, especially and only if you have a solid, guaranteed way to repay that loan. I'm never a fan of incur I'm never wanting to encourage anyone to take out a loan or become indebted to anyone. So it's really hard for me to say that taking out a loan is a good idea. If you have to, okay. Not okay. But at least you should know that I believe that access taking out a loan and repaying your loan is not a taxable event. So consult a tax professional and make sure that that is correct. But that could be a workaround from cashing out your crypto and having to deal with the tax repercussions of that. So centralized exchanges are, especially I'm talking about Binance here, they make it, they're trying their very best to be the end-all be-all solution for anything you could ever need in crypto, which has its pros and cons just like everything else. But they want to encourage you to keep your coins on their exchange, in their possession. I don't know if you know this, but centralized exchanges are kind of known for taking your coins and doing things with them that benefit them, that earn them more money. But just definitely something to be aware of, that even though it is a lot more easy and convenient to be staking your coins on something like a centralized exchange, it doesn't mean it should be or is your best solution. Well, again, Binance has that staking page where there's all these coins that you can stake on Binance. And if you're not careful, it's easy to think that you get a sense that all these coins are equal and that they are all legitimate. But this is not true. Don't be misled by convenience. Take each investment you make seriously. Don't invest in a coin that you haven't researched. Don't invest what you consider to be a valuable amount of money into a project which you only know what like the cheerleaders of that coin have said. I definitely encourage you to search out the other side, search out the opposing side and understand the criticisms before you make a decision, especially if you're considering like a long-term investment. So here, lastly, I'm going to go over the coins and what I value in them and why I have chosen to invest in them.